For students to get the most out of inquiry-based learning, there are a number of inquiry skills that need to be nurtured. Some of the most important of these skills can be found in the curriculum and are easy to refer back to. Inquiry helps students develop critical thinking, project planning skills, and communication abilities, amongst many other skills. But does taking time to assess inquiry-based skills mean that the traditional assessment of content understanding has to go by the wayside? Not necessarily. The understanding of content can be assessed while doing inquiry-based learning. What's useful to remember is that assessment does not always have to come in the form of written quizzes and tests, as will be described later. It is possible to have inquiry become the heart of the classroom. The curriculum presents four inquiry skill sets that every student needs to develop. Let's take a look at these four sets of skills. Part of the inquiry process is students showing that they can brainstorm solutions to a problem, select a possible solution to the problem, and make a plan for how they will implement the solution. Once Andrea's students have had time to become familiar with the inquiry materials and are ready to move on to more guided inquiry that requires planning, Andrea's strategy will be to eavesdrop on the student conversations. As she is facilitating the activity, Andrea will walk around the room with a student list. She'll listen in on the students discussing the details of how they will solve the problem at hand. If necessary, Andrea will probe students to get further information.
Okay, so how about we have a couple of people working on
it? An important component of the experimental process is the collection of data. It's necessary for students to learn to slow down, and really think about the results of their experimentation in order to fully understand what has transpired in the activity. Data collection can be performed by anyone, even the youngest grades. Some good ways for students to record their results is to create drawings, diagrams, or graphs which can later be assessed. It's not enough for students to simply collect data. After an activity, students need to try to make sense of what they've observed and experienced. While analyzing data, it's important for students to recognize that data collected is not always going to lead to a conclusion that's easy to spot. For some experiments, pattern recognition through the collection of multiple data points is the key to making a strong conclusion. Even with a grade 2 class, Andrea is able to help students tease out a pattern from the data they collected.
How smaller do you think if I give you four textbooks?
Bigger.
That's right.
Another important element of inquiry-based learning is students communicating the results of the work they've done. Fortunately, many students love to talk about their work, and it just so happens that it's a great way for them to show that they understand what they did. A perfect assessment opportunity for Andrea. In her class, Andrea and her students can take advantage of many different communication tools, from drawings to student-teacher interviews.
We didn't make all of them straight or else it would go too fast.
So you brought them up a bit?
Yeah.
Excellent.
Andrea can also see if her students are able to make use of grade-appropriate vocabulary found in the curriculum.
Tell me about your design.
The reason is why we made it this way. If we made it really flat, it will be more harder and it will be really steep.
So this way, it's less steep.
Because the elementary school teacher's time is limited, having students communicate the results of their work is a good time to do some cross-curricular assessment. By doing some science inquiry, for example, it's quite possible to obtain evidence of learning from the language curriculum or the arts curriculum. Imagine, for example, Andrea getting her students to write a short story about the adventures of the St. Bernard in their inclined plane activity. To learn more about assessment, a good starting point is to look at the Ministry of Education document, Growing Success. This document provides a good overview of how to gather evidence of learning by balancing the gathering of observations, conversations, and student products. Find out more by following the link below.